busy. After retiring, Joan spent the last decade researching and documenting her own family tree. Tonight's program is Christmas Through the Ages. Her stories will jump from pages to the stage in the form of live performance and improvisations troupe that was put together just for us here at the Genealogy Society. Joan, it's all yours.
Christmas Through the Ages, she asked me, what could we do to help liven it up a bit? And I suggested, how about doing a performance, a live performance, that includes improv or improvisation. Now, by applause, how many of you have been to an improv show before? Nice, nice. And how many have not, by applause? Okay. Lots of new recruits right there.
Yeah.
Okay, so what improv is we make it up right on the spot, inspired by your suggestions and tonight by Joan's stories. From time to time, we're going to be asking you for suggestions. So if I was to ask you, what was your first car that you owned? You would say?
Pontiac.
A little bit louder, let's hear them.
Pontiac.
Pontiac, okay. No Model T's?
No Model T's.
Okay. If I was to ask over here, what is your favorite color?
Blue.
Blue. Yeah, everybody loves blue. Everybody loves blue for Christmas. Okay, and over here, if somebody was to call you with a 239-277 number, what would you do? Hang up! You were listening! I love this smart audience. This is wonderful. This is going to be even more special because improv is a show that's never been seen before and never will again because we're making it up. In fact, it's really special tonight because the five of us have never performed or even rehearsed before. So we have no idea what's going to happen. In fact, we're going to be learning the show as you do. I am Joe. I'm with the Just the Funny Theater in Miami.
I'm Bill Owens. I'm with Bonita City Improv in Bonita Springs.
My name is Steve Cobb. I'm from Bonita City Improv and Gene Pool Party up in Bonita Springs.
I'm Alex Nay, and I'm with Comedy School Dropouts.
I'm Joey Nay, and I'm also part of Comedy School Dropouts in Miami.
Okay. Now, even though we were talking about Presbyterian graveyards and we're in a church, I did get special permission for you to laugh. So if you do see anything humorous throughout the evening, please go ahead and laugh. That's the only way that we get paid. Joan, why don't you take it away with your first topic?
The Christmas truce. The Christmas truce refers to an unofficial ceasefire during World War I on the Western Front, involving approximately 100,000 German, French, and British troops on opposite trenches. It began when the Germans decorated their side with candles and started singing Christmas carols. The British and the French responded with their own Christmas carols. Then both sides yelled Christmas greetings to each other. Shortly after, a few brave men from both sides walked into no man's land to mingle with their enemy and exchange small gifts and souvenirs. The truce was short-lived, with the men eventually retreating back to their respective trenches to resume fighting.
We're going to start things off real simple with a basic scene game. So we're going to have two or three people come out, do some scenes loosely based on what we just heard, the Christmas truce, and maybe a suggestion from the audience. Give me a non-geographical location where you like to spend the holidays, like the beach or something like that. Anybody?
The golf.
Where?
The Gulf.
The Gulf. The Gulf of Mexico?
Yeah.
Okay, the Gulf of Mexico it is. Players?
It's like getting away from the snow, huh?
Yeah, yeah. I just got down here. swim trunks.
Oh.
It's, so kind of to mend the fences, so to speak, I got you a fruitcake.
You know what? It's the thought that counts, and this is a beautiful gesture, so thank you.
Is that fruitcake?
Yes, clownfish.
You never let a clownfish eat fruitcake. Chocolate to a dog. It's a horrible thing to do.
Oh, we'll be fine.
Oh.
And part of the holidays is sharing.
Vive la France. I have just rolled over with a baguette as a paddle.
Oh, monsieur, it's French Santa Claus. Thank you for coming to visit us.
Yes, I brought you many treats. Chocolat.
Chocolat, we haven't had that in 30 years. We have been blockaded from the war.
That dawn will
make good with the chocolate.
I'll present it once.
Oh, thank you. Is this all you brought?
Well, it's French chocolat. It is from France.
I mean, it's one bar. It's one bar in France.
I'll get more.
Okay, au revoir.
Au revoir.
Look, he brought one bar of chocolate.
How will we ration it for the whole season?
Oh, hey. I guess we won't have any for the rest of the season.
Oh, you meant golf. You wanted to go golfing.
Yeah.
Oh, I brought you here to Naples for nothing then, eh? I brought you to the beach. I thought you wanted to see water for the first time in your life.
I thought we were going to be working on a little, sand game,
Excuse me, guys. Are you going to tee or what? Because we got to force them back here. We're going to need to keep this moving.
Beach golf?
Awesome.
You gotta be kidding me, that's the best thing in the world. Oh, yeah.
You go first.
Okay.
Wait. Line it up a little bit. There you go.
I like how you touched me.
Well, it's more where that came from. Line it up this way.
No, this... You used to be so distant from me. I like how you're comfortable with being around me now.
The holidays just brings people together. It's kind of like the Germans and the French. I mean, they just figured out how to make it work. And then they killed each other.
All right, kids, gather around. We're going to light the menorah.
Oh, can I light it?
Yes.
Okay, you'll light the main candle in the center. Okay, don't burn yourself. Be careful.
What do I do with this?
Blow it out.
Oh.
Happy birthday.
Close. But now we're going to take this candle and light the first candle for the first
time. Oh, can I light it? steps and sit in a chair, and you're going to give us some words. So anybody like to volunteer? It's your chance to be on stage. Yes, you, sir, right there. Anybody else? From this side. A lady, perhaps. From this side, anyone? Anyone?
Come on, here. All right.
Walter, a big round of applause.
Yeah, Walter.
Joyce, give her a round of applause. She's been there in her chair. So we're going to play a game for you, and our actors sometimes get struck for words. They don't know what to say. So they're going to count on our two volunteers, Walter and Joyce, to help them out. So they may come up to you, Joyce, and tap you on the shoulder or point to you, and your job is to give them any word that comes to your mind, anything at all. It doesn't have to make sense because they're professionals. They're going to make it make sense. And your job too, Walter, so anybody can tap you. So if they said, I'm in Publix and I'm in the produce section and I would like to buy a?
Rutabaga.
A rutabaga, right. You would buy a rutabaga at Publix in the produce section. But you can also say something crazy like a small baby or a car or whatever you want because it's their job to make sense of it. And if they were to tap you on the shoulder and say, I'm so tired, I need to...
Go play golf.
Go play golf. And they have to justify whatever you say. So you have the easy job. There's no wrong answer for you. You just say whatever comes to your mind when they tap you. All right? So I'm going to get two players up here. What I need from you all is a suggestion of maybe a holiday tradition, since we're in the holiday season.
Decorating the Christmas tree.
Decorating the Christmas tree. Excellent. Players, begin.
Really? You let me do it last year.
Okay, I'll do it.
Oh, okay.
We'll
careful.
Do it together.
Great.
You grab one side.
Okay.
All right.
Ready?
One.
Two.
Well, we have to say our special word when we put it up. We have to say...
Okay.
Bangladesh.
Bangladesh.
Because that's the first celebrating Christmas.
Absolutely.
Joyce Hammer-Schmidt from the Naples Gazette. The people want to know, who are you wearing? And by wearing, I mean
Sam Smith from the Naples Daily News, the paper that comes out on Saturday for Sunday, was married that
week. Mary, unfortunately, she was feeling a little under the weather, you know, with pregnancy and whatnot.
David Nelson from the GSCC newsletter. My read is like to know about genealogy. So, is it true that you had a cousin, an American cousin?
An American cousin. We're still looking into that. Again, that's why I'm here. I need you guys to help me figure that out. If I did have an American cousin or not. But yes, sir.
Hi, Rabbi Shevitz from Christmas Enthusiasts.
Okay.
I'd like to kind of have you explain, you know, how you all of a sudden have an aversion to theater.
Well, if I may quote the last play that I saw is I Am Not Throwing Away My Shot. All right, and so, you know, while that does leave me to have an aversion of the theater, I am willing to give it another shot. All right. Yes, sir.
Steve Higginbotham Smith,
yes.
Jr., the third, from the Markle Island Registry and Obituary Column. Anyways, my question is, are you sure you didn't throw away the shot?
I didn't. You're from the obituary column, right? Because I have a bone to pick. I believe my last name was misspelled wrong. It's L-I-N-C-O-L-N. A lot of people
my office is out on the west side of 41.
Oh, okay.
So anyways, overtly doing something at this location?
Well, there is a lot of whispering involved in the library. When you steal a book, is that what it is?
Come on. do, where would I go?
All right. This really went in a weird direction, but any ideas yet? Okay, all right, that's good. Well, let's go ahead and go back to the questioners.
Are you a strict constructionist?
Were you named after the apple?
Anything closer or more confused? I think I'm saying more confused. Alright, we'll really hone it in this time. All right.
You would think you would be on the $2 bill.
Perfume soap say, all I want is a little bubbly.
walk into a bar and the bartender says, I'm sorry, we don't serve fruitcakes here. And 185 fruitcakes say, I thought this was that kind of bar.
185 fruitcakes walk into a bar. Bartender says, I can't serve you 185 fruitcakes. 185 fruitcakes say, why not? And the bartender says, it's not just us. Nobody wants fruitcake.
Oh,
okay.
185 fruitcakes walk into the bar, and the bartender says, I cannot serve you 185 fruitcakes. And the fruitcakes say, why not? And the bartender says, because every time you come in here, all you want is a cup of slice.
Oh.
Yes.
185 fruitcakes walk into a bar. Bartender says, I'm sorry, we don't serve fruitcakes here. And 185 fruitcakes say, what gave us away?
Okay. That's our show, everybody. Thank you so much.
Thank you for letting us play and participate. Thanks to Joe for including us. Bill and I are members of an improv troupe right here in Southwest Florida. In Bonita Springs, we do monthly shows once a month at the Bonita Center for the Arts on Bonita Beach Road. We do a lot of musical improv. We have a musician that makes up songs. We sing. We do a lot of fun stuff. So if you like what you see here, or if you kind of liked it a little, come and see us at our show. The first Saturday of every month, I have some flyers that I can hand you. You can just see me in the back. But we perform. Our next show is January 6th on Saturday. So come support local theater and come and have a good time and laugh a little bit. Thank you, guys.
Thank you.
Thank you so very much, and thank you, Joan, for suggesting the program for tonight.